We're chatting about GE, Google and MTN today, and GE numbers coming out, and it looks like this is a company that is seen as a barometer of the US economy, and it looks pretty positive.
Yeah, look, it's been a very tough and long haul for them, because in 2008 they basically fell from around $35 all the way down to the market low in March 2009 at around $7. So absolutely devastating for one of America's kind of preeminent companies. But just to recap, this is a concern that covers everything from industrial heavy equipment, power stations, wind turbines, steam locomotives, a huge business.
Kettles
in
and toasters.
Well, that's the thing that they started with way back in Thomas Edison's days, but it's kind of evolved from that. The major business that they have in there also is aircraft engines, very profitable. But then in the Jack Welch era, they supplemented it with financial services, some of it linked to the industrial business, but a lot of it just in the kind of mass wholesale finance market. And as you can imagine, with the financial crisis hammering everybody, they got hammered too. And it's taken a long time to recover, even though the order flow has been quite good. But it came out with solid numbers overnight. It's now sort of 5 or 6% up. It's at the $20 level. So think about that, from, you know, 35, 40 all the way down to 7 and now back to 20. We think it's one of those stocks that people ought to look at, although you do have to accept it's like a diversified industrial, like say Bidvest or others, that has lots of different moving parts, and you're not always sure whether all of them are going to be firing at the same time.
Yeah, I suppose you have to look at that two ways, that you're either shielded when one part falls off or breaks apart or something.
That's true.
But if you want to be a bit more focused, would you really want to go into a conglomerate like General Electric?
Perhaps not, although it depends on your objectives. You know, so if you liked particularly the aviation business, you might consider Boeing directly, or if you preferred, you know, the environmental technology area, you may look at a company in Denmark that makes air Vestas, you know, that makes wind turbines. But I think as a sort of one-stop shop, GE certainly does it. And maybe there's the idea that in time there could be some unbundlings and separations. I mean, GE is the parent of this channel, CNBC. One of the assets they own.
You're saying, watch what you say, Stephen.
Well, it's a few levels from where we stand this afternoon. But I guess you could say that the separation of that NBC Universal business, which has been sold to Comcast, is the harbinger of transactions to come for GE, and that in a decade or two's time, you might get all that sort of sum of the parts breaking up value unlock as well.
Well, we're looking at Google as well. Their numbers were out after the bell last night, I think. Good response from the markets when the shares started trading. And it looks like tech stocks are really back in flavor.
Plus the change of CEO, because remember that company founded by Larry and Sergey. Then they brought in the grown-up manager because they figured they needed the assistance in terms of developing the company. Now Page is a little bit older. He's going to take over as CEO, and Eric Schmidt is moving into the background. But what a company. I mean, apart from their strength in internet search, which everybody knows, they have YouTube, which is the way of the future. I mean, clips from these shows are shown on YouTube at a delayed basis. They've got the AdSense and AdWorks business, and then Gmail, which is another major winner. One senses they do need to get into the social networking area. You know, Facebook, Twitter, and these other applications are starting to kind of make gains. They've had a couple of attempts to do that. But I think at around $600 a share, certainly one that ought to look at.
I have to point out the clips from these shows are also shown on ABN Digital Pulse, so I hope you'll be...
That's the location, served by YouTube.
Served by YouTube. Finally, quickly, MTN up 3% today, so one of our local companies...
Look, I know we're out of time, but there's a lot of noise out there. Nigeria looks as though the political transition's going well. They've been quite volatile, but it's a stock that has really seen significant volume in recent days, and I'm quite interested to know why it's been moving around so much. Maybe some reasons will emerge next week.
We're chatting to Wayne McCurry, and he says it's one of his favorites just because of the value portion that's going to kick into play and the dividends you could expect.
It's a major emerging markets value story, and it really benefits from strong inflows when people are liking the emerging markets. At other times, though, it seems to be one that gets hit in the face first when markets are a little bit negative, so maybe there's nothing more to it than that.